Let's balance the equation for Fe plus CuSO4. We have iron metal plus copper 2 sulfate. So we'll balance the equation, look at the type of reaction, then we'll write the states in. So first off, let's count the atoms up on each side of the equation. One iron atom, one copper atom. And then for SO4, this is a polyatomic ion. It appears on both sides. So we're going to count that as one thing. When you balance equations by doing that, you save a lot of time. You get the same answer either way, just saves time. So SO4, we have one of those sulfate ions. Product side, we have one iron and one copper. And then again, we have one sulfate ion. And you can see very clearly here, we're done. This equation is balanced. If you needed to report the coefficients, they'd be 1, 1, 1, 1, but we don't write that by convention. To write the states, Fe, that's iron, elemental iron. Same with copper. So that's going to be, both of those are solid. Copper 2 sulfate, sulfates in general, they're soluble. So that's going to be aqueous. It's actually going to be a blue solution because of this copper 2 ion in here. So we have our blue solution, and then we'll have our iron 2 sulfate over here. This is also aqueous. It's going to be a clear solution. So you start out this blue solution and you end up with a clear solution when the reaction's complete. The type of reaction here, the iron is replacing the copper. It's pushing the copper out of the solution here. So now we have solid copper. It falls to the bottom of the test tube. The iron, it dissolves or disappears. It's now aqueous, dissolved in the water with this FeSO4 aqueous solution. So this is a single replacement reaction. That's the type of reaction. This is Dr. B with the balanced equation and the type of reaction for Fe plus CuSO4, iron plus copper 2 sulfate. Thanks for watching.